Good morning and welcome to Camp Hope AME Church, located at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. God has kindly woke us up this morning and started us on our way. I don't know about you, but I need a word from the Lord today. Pray with us that God will give us what we need today, that we might carry on, that we might be the light of the world. I'd like to welcome Sister William Moten, Reverend Latanya Renfro. Amen. Sister Cornelius, welcome, welcome, welcome. Amen. I'd like to welcome out there on the phone line Sister Betty Strickland, Brother Curtis Lowe, Brother Henry Lowe, Sister Annie Waller. Amen. I'd like to welcome Sister Eddie May Hall. Amen. And those out there in Florida. Amen. Hallelujah. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Before we get into our announcements this morning, we will watch a short video from AME Vic Alert. The Alert.
General election on Tuesday, November the 3rd. I thank AME, The Alert, for asking me to join with them. I accept the challenge. It's our watch. Hashtag vote and take a buddy. I wish I could take Floyd, but it's too late for that. Will you stand in for him and others that have been senselessly murdered? Thank you. What time is it? It's time to vote as if our lives depend upon it, because it does. Hello, my name is Jonathan Veal, and I'm a childhood friend and high school teammate of George Floyd. Little would I believe that my guy, your new acquaintance, would have an impact on the entire globe, moving people to get involved, to say, I get it, to declare that Black Lives Matter. The way we can say it powerfully is to vote in the general election on Tuesday, November the 3rd. I thank AME, The Alert, for asking me to join with them. I accept the challenge. It's our watch. Hashtag vote and take a buddy. I wish I could take Floyd, but it's too late for that. Will you stand in for him and others that have been senselessly murdered? Thank you.
All right, let us go right into our announcements. Amen. Our prayer line every Tuesday is at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 6 p.m. Central Standard Time, hosted by none other than the Reverend Latanya Renfro and Reverend Ida Sue Graham. Join in with us as we make our request to the Lord. Join in with us as we listen to testimonies, as we sing songs, as we come together in agreement, knowing that if we could be in agreement, God will be in the midst and God will answer our prayers. Call in on our prayer line, 978-990-5041, access code 675-984. Also, our prayer line, as you see printed on the screen there, amen. Remember all of those names. If you don't see the name of your loved ones or those that need prayer, please let us know who they are. We will add them to our prayer list. Also, remember to follow us on Facebook. Tell people to come out on Facebook and follow us and to like us, amen, and like our broadcast. Also on YouTube, go out and subscribe to us. Watch old videos. Watch videos and Bible studies from past Sundays and past Wednesdays. Also, you can find us on Instagram as well. Amen. Also, remember, you also can become a virtual member with us here at Camp Hope AMB Church. Doesn't matter where you're located. We have people now in France. We have people now in Germany. We have people now all across the United States. If God moves you to become a member with us here at Camp Hope, come and be a virtual member and worship right from your home, because God said there will be a time when we won't worship God in this mountain, in these buildings, but we will worship God in spirit and in truth. Send a personal Facebook message. Email us at camphopeamec@gmail.com or write us at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia 31211. And always remember our Bible study, which is on Wednesday at 6:30 p.m., 5:30 Central Standard Time, amen, 6:30 Eastern Standard Time on Facebook Live, or call in at 978-990-5041. Of course, access code 675-984. God is a good God, and His mercy endures forever. Remember that this Tuesday, amen, September the 29th, we will have our quarterly conference, amen. All boards and auxiliaries, please submit your reports for my review, amen. Also, remember our sponsors, amen. Our sponsors, the Giffen Sisters, amen. Let's go out there and patronize them, for they are truly supporting us. We would like to also thank our media staff, amen, led by Sister Deborah Brundage, amen, and brought on by Sister Brittany Winston, amen, and her crew, amen. We thank you, thank you, thank you for being with us, amen. I see we see Sister Curry's here with us this morning, and Sister Sylvia Pitts and Sister Latanya Butler. Welcome, welcome, as we get started this morning to come together and worship with the Lord. Also, we just like to thank those who have become a part of our Capital Mortgage and let you know that we are working diligently to get ourselves prepared to celebrate the great mortgage burning. We've sent out all the masks, we sent out all the shirts, and we will let you know when we want you to take pictures or even come on Facebook and show that you are supportive of Camp Hope AME Church. Amen. And for those that's out there on the Justice team and the Harmony team, remember, keep working forward that they might reach their goal. Let God be with you. God will direct you. God will direct your path. Also remember, we are about to go into our mid-year convocation. It will be October the 14th through the 17th in Augusta, Georgia. Amen. Stay tuned for other announcements in our future. Amen. So let's sit back and listen to our praise and worship this morning.
speak a word over yourself. Depression is all around, but God is a present help. Well, the enemy created walls, but remember giants, they do fall. Speak of yourself, encourage yourself.
Amen. I see Sister Burns has joined in with us. Amen. Sister Betty Desire. Amen. Reverend Ida Sue Graham has joined with us. Amen. Let us be encouraged. Let's get right into our call to worship. Amen. As I say what the ministers say, you join in with me when I say what the people should say. So let's get started. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Our feet shall stand within your gates, O Jerusalem. Come on, say it with me. For a day in your courts is better than 1,000 elsewhere. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness. Because of the house of the Lord, our God, I will seek thy good. Come on, say it with me. Those that be planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Blessed are they that dwelleth in the house. Lord, I have loved thy habitation, the place where thy honor dwelleth. Come on, say it with me. For the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silence before him. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Come on, say it with me. Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. I will sing of loyalty and of justice to you, O Lord, I will sing. And let us sit back and enjoy our hymn of praise.
Put those hands together all across the building tonight. Let the devil know that you're encouraged. Let him know that you're encouraged. Let him know. Hallelujah. I don't know about you tonight, but somebody may be crying, but I come to let you know that God can make it all right.
It's impossible to see, but God is gonna work it out if you just believe. Remember this one thing while you're going through. If God delivered Daniel, guess what? He'll do the same for you. Hey.
No matter what's going on, he'll make it all right.
Said it in his word.
Just
a test of your faith. So stand strong and dry your weeping eyes. 'Cause joy comes in the morning and everything is gonna be alright.
Yeah, fast and unmovable, always
standing on shaky ground. You have no hand to hold. Jesus said, Lord, I'll be always, even until the end of the world. I'll be there for you.
Hallelujah. Be encouraged. I see Sister Hall has joined us. Welcome, Sister Hall. Amen. Let's go right into prayer and remember, amen, to remember all of those that are out there on our prayer list. And again, if you didn't see your name or the name of you, who you wanted on prayer list, please let us know. We will add it to that prayer list. Amen. Let us go into prayer. God, we just thank you, we praise you, we glorify you, for you're truly worthy to be praised. Lord, if we had 10,000 tongues, we could not praise you enough. Mm-hmm. Thank you for waking us up this morning, starting us on our way, keeping us in our right mind, knowing that this is where we should be right now, worshiping you, praising you, have an ear to you, waiting for you to give us bread from heaven, give us drink from heaven. We thank you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for sending your son to die for us, that we might be covered in his blood, that we might be crowned as the righteous, that we can boldly come before your throne of grace and mercy. Lord, we say thank you, Lord. Lord, we say thank you for taking us through our bad decisions and letting it be a lesson for us to learn, and all things working out for our good. Lord, thank you for protecting us from the weapons that may have been launched up against us. Amen. It looked like they have destroyed us, but we came out all right, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us to get beyond our misunderstanding with our own self, with our desperateness and depression and our confused minds when we get into troubles that we can't understand and seem like they're out of control. We thank you for being with us and carrying us through, Lord. And we thank you ahead of time for hearing our prayers and answering our prayers, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, hear the prayers of your loved ones. Hear the prayers of those that are called. Hear the prayers that you have called to join us on this virtual and on our call line. Hear our humble prayers and let us know that you're with us. You will never leave us nor forsake us. Forgive us for our sins, Lord, for truly we sin and fall short of your glory. Lord, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. This is our prayer. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and thank God. Amen. Pull out your swords. Amen. And let's go right into our scripture reading. Amen. Our scripture reading will come from 1 Samuel chapter 30, verses 1 through 8. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verses 1 through 8. Amen. Give you a moment to pull out your swords to get there. Amen. Again, 1 Samuel chapter 30, verses 1 through 8. And it is on your screen. Let us read. And it came to pass when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day that the Amalekites had invaded the south and Ziklag and smitted Ziklag and burned it with fire, and had taken the women captives that were therein. They slew not any, either great or small, but carried them away and went on their way. So David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burned with fire, and their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captive. Then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept, until they had no more power to weep. And David's two wives were taken captive, Ahinoam and the Jezreelite, and Abigail, the wife of Nabal the Carmelite. And David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people were grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. And David said to Abiathar the priest, Ahimelech's son, I pray thee, bring me hither the ephod. And Abiathar brought thither the ephod to David. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. From all that dwells below the skies, let the Creator's praise arise. Let the Redeemer's name be sung through every land by every tongue. Let us sing together in a cappella the Decalogue. From all that dwells below the sky, let thy Creator's praise arise. Let thy Redeemer's name be sung through every land by every tongue. The sum of the Decalogue, hear what Christ our Savior saith. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Let us sing, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. 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 It's time for our benevolent and tithes and offering. Amen. We just thank all of our partners that have come and allowed us to operate through their gifts. We could not do it without it. Amen. So we thank you in your giving. No amount is too small. Amen. Let God allow you to be his hand. Let God allow you to be her support to this ministry. We ask all of the members, amen, that you would at this time pay your benevolence and your tithes and offerings. And a link has been put out there for you to click on, amen, to give, amen. If you don't want to give that way, you can mail your offerings into Camp Hope AME Church, located at 114 Camp Hope Church Road, Macon, Georgia, 31211. And for all of those that are our partners, remember, always pay your tithes and your offering where God has blessed you to be a member. Amen. Everything above and beyond your tithes and offering is where your blessings are found, your gifts. That's where God opens up the window and pour you out blessings to receive. But make sure you support where you are, because these are difficult times and difficult season, and God has put a plan from the beginning of how we as his people shall support the kingdom that she has allowed us to be a part of. Our God is a great God. Amen. So let's get right into our musical selection before the Word of God.
It seems there's no way out. I know the issue seems unchangeable, and that there's no reason to shout, but the impossible is God's chance to work a miracle, so just know it ain't over until God says it's over, it ain't over. until God says it's done. No, 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 it ain't over until God says it's over. Keep fighting until your victory is won.
Until God says, It ain't over.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It ain't over till God says it's over. Let's go back to our scripture reading. Amen. Again, 1 Samuel chapter 30, verses 1 through 8. First Samuel chapter 30, verses 1 through 8. Amen. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verses 1 through 8. And it came to pass when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day, that the Amalekites had invaded the south and Ziklag, and smitten Ziklag and burned it with fire. And verse 3, so David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burnt with fire, and their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captive. Then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voices and wept until they had no more power to weep. Verse 6, and David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the souls of all the people were grieved, every man for his sons and for his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord. In verse 8, and David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail, recover all. Welcome to my sister, amen. Sister Melvia Martin, amen. Welcome to Brother Frank Williams for joining in with us today. Let us pray. Lord God, we just thank and we praise you for allowing us to be your vessel. Lord, if I've done anything in thought, word, and deed that from hinder you from speaking to your people, from feeding your people, for them getting revelation and understanding and become a stronger light, change what it is that has to be said and let them hear from heaven, Lord. Let the preacher come. Let the preacher reside in me and preach whatever word that you would have preached. Lord, I thank you. I praise you. Cover me in the blood of Jesus. You are my rock. You are my salvation. In Jesus' name, I pray. If you're in agreement with me, say amen, amen, and amen. Now say to yourself, be encouraged. Come on, say it one more time. Say it to yourself, be encouraged. You know, God got you. God's got you. You know, here in 1 Samuel, we find David living a life as a fugitive. A man on the run, one who has been driven from his home. Even though as a youth he was anointed and appointed by God to be the next king of Israel. Now, don't think David put himself in this predicament. No, he didn't. It really wasn't his fault. He was in a predicament because the presiding king, King Saul, had set in his mind to kill David. You see, Saul had been rejected by God because of his disobedience. God had instructed him through the prophet Samuel, the last judge of Israel, to go and totally destroy the Amalekites. When God had brought the children out of Israel, out of slavery in Egypt, and was directing them through towards the promised land, the Amalekites unprovokedly, for no reason at all, attacked them. And even though they lost, slaughtered a great number of the Israelites. Saul was to destroy everything and leave no one alive. Now, Saul did kill all the men, women, and children and poor quality livestock, but he leaves the king and the best of the livestock alive. It says he was so proud of his victory that he set up a monument in his own honor, a statue in Carmel. When Samuel learned that Saul had not obeyed his instruction, he informed Saul that God had rejected him as the king of Israel due to his disobedience. The text goes on to say, and the spirit of the Lord left Samuel, and an evil spirit took his place. And Saul, being tormented by this evil spirit, had become paranoid and jealous of how people serenaded David in his victories compared to his own. Saul had become convinced that David was going to take away his throne. So Saul set in his mind to kill David. So as you can see, life has not been so easy for David and his men at this particular point in history. I want you to say to yourself, be encouraged. Come on, say to yourself, be encouraged. Have you ever been in a situation where your friends turned their backs on you? They've all decided to turn against you. They seem more critical towards you than your enemies. Now, I'm not talking about associates, people who are casually coming in and out of your life. I'm talking about people you have given your all to. You've gone out on the limb for them. You sacrificed for them, went out of your way to make sure their needs were met and that they were all right. Have you ever had your closest friends, your Ace Boone Coons, your ride and die crew turn on you? Blamed you for their present predicament and you yourself had been affected just as badly as they have been? If you have, how did it make you feel? Did you feel distressed? Did you become discouraged? And when you really thought about it, you realized that it may have been your fault that they were in the predicament that all of you have found yourselves in. You did make the decision. You did do something to cause it to happen. You may not have done it by yourself, but you were the leader of the group. They were following your orders, allowing you to guide them alongside in the events that took place. You may have won the victory, but at what cost? It happened because they befriended you. It happened because they followed you, took your side, and stood with you. Have you ever been there? Nobody will be standing with you, take up for you, or be on your side. They've all turned on you and are ready to destroy you and stand against you for what has happened to them. Say to yourself, be encouraged. Now, this is where David found himself in our text this morning. If you would go back and read 1 Samuel chapter 27 later, you will find that David, along with 600 men and their families, fled from Saul and hid in the enemy's territory of the Palestinians. David thought that they would be safe from King Saul in the enemy's territory. As I said before, King Saul had set in his mind to kill David. David had thought to himself in 1 Samuel chapter 27, verse 1, One of these days, I will be destroyed by the hand of Saul. The best thing I can do is to escape to the land of the Palestinians. Then Saul will give up searching for me anywhere in Israel, and I will slip out of his hands. And at this point, it had worked. For if we read a little farther in the text, when Saul was told that David had fled to Gath, he no longer searched for him. While in this territory, David and his men joined leagues with the king of Gath. Achish and settled in a place called Ziklag. David and his army fought war and won battles against the Geshurites, the Gergites, and the Amalekites. And after they had conquered them, they did not leave a man or a woman alive and took all their sheep, took all their cattle, donkeys and camels, and even all their clothing and brought it back to Achish, the king. And the king was so impressed with David that Achish trusted him and said to himself, he has become so obnoxious to his people, the Israelites, that he will be my servant for life. For you see, David had lied to the king and told him he was attacking the southern regions of Judah, not Geshurites, the Gergites, and the Amalekites. David did this so he would win favor with the king. For approximately 1 year and 4 months, life felt much better for David and his men. They were now a part of a great territory, and they were enjoying the safety from Saul and were experiencing victory in every battle they had fought. Life was good. Everything was working out just as they planned it and believed that it would. Have you been there? You found some folks who believed in you and what you stood for. Have you been there? They stood by you and with you. They were there during your trials and tribulations. They were there during your good times and your bad times. You were there for them and ensured everything worked out for them. You fought battles together against the naysayers and those who plotted against you. And everyone prevailed. Everyone shared in the victory. And life just appeared as though it would be good from this point on. Or so it seemed. David and his men were now at ease. They didn't have to run anymore. They had found refuge in the enemy's camp. But now the tables were about to turn. In chapter 29, Achish wanted David and his men to join the war against Israel. But the Philistines didn't want David to join them. Although the king trusted David, the Philistine commanders didn't. They said, "Isn't this the David they sang about in their dances? Saul has slain his thousands and David his 10,000. Send this man back, that he may return to the place you assigned him. He must not go with us into battle, or he will turn against us during the fighting. How better could he regain his master's favor than by taking the heads of our own men?" You know, even though you may have gained your leader's trust, it does not necessarily mean that you have gained the trust of those around them. So Achish sent David and his men back to Ziklag. Oh, but when they got there, say to yourself, "Be encouraged." Our text says David and his men found the town had been burned down. It was a rubbish pile. Every man's wife and child had been taken. The Amalekites took the opportunity while the Philistines were all gathered to the north to attack King Saul and the Israelites to ravage the southern territories of their land. They had come and destroyed the town and taken everyone captive. How many know that God has a plan? Say to yourself, "Be encouraged." Remember earlier in the story when David and his men attacked the Amalekites? Not only did they burn the cities and took all its belongings, they killed every man, every woman and child. But in return, the Amalekites kept everybody alive. Say to yourself, "God has a plan." You see, first and foremost, David had made a controversial decision to find refuge with the Philistines. David was a man of God, and the Philistines were enemies of God's people. He had linked up with God's enemies for protection instead of trusting God to protect him in the situation he had found himself in. He was looking to man rather than depending on God. Have you been there? The bottom has fallen out from under you. You've given all to the company you work for, and your boss has turned on you and want to get rid of you. They are doing anything and everything to make sure you are through. And you find yourself caught up in this situation. You turn to everybody but God. You put your trust in man rather than God. David and his men were so upset that the text said they wept aloud until they had no strength to weep anymore. And then they got mad. They were so angry that they were talking about stoning David. And David becoming greatly distressed because of this. Each one of his men had become so bitter in his spirit because of the loss of his sons and daughters. They wanted to kill David, even though David was in the same predicament they found themselves in. But the text says David encouraged himself. He didn't talk to himself, oh, this is going to work out. Everything's going to get over. They're going to get over. They're just mad. He didn't just motivate himself. Oh, I can stick it out. Oh, just keep yourself together. He encouraged himself in the Lord. He remembered who he was and whom he belonged to. He remembered God would never leave him or forsake him. He remembered that the battle was not his, but it was the Lord. David called the priest and told him to bring the ephod. You see, the ephod was worn when the leader wanted to question God, get God's advice, get instructions from God on what they should do. When things get out of control and you find yourself in a grievous situation that causes you to go into a state of depression, what do you do? Do you encourage yourself in the Lord? Do you call on the Lord? Do you know that God's got you? And Abimelech, the priest, brought the ephod to David. And David inquired at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this truth? Shall I overtake them? And God answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. If you consult with the Lord, we can be like David, and we can say, as Paul says in 2 Corinthians 7, 4 through 6, I was greatly encouraged. And in all my troubles, my joy knows no bounds. For when we came to you, this body of ours had no rest. But we were harassed at every turn, conflicts on the outside and fears on the inside. But God, who comforts the downtrodden, comforted me. David consulted the Lord, and the Lord said to him, pursue. No matter what the situation is, no matter what the circumstances are, pursue. God's got you. For those who have taken from you and caused you to dwindle in your faith, they may have taken from you the happiness in your marriage. They may have influenced your children to turn against you. They may have stolen hard-earned money and clouded your prosperity, caused you to lose your job, lose your position in the ministry, tarnish your reputation before all. God says, pursue. When you catch up with them, you can confidently say to them, I didn't come to cooperate or negotiate or even collaborate with you. I came to get my stuff back. You can say to them, I didn't come to make peace with you, to tell you you won. I came to retaliate, to eliminate, to dominate. I came to get my stuff back. I have come back to take back my faith, to take back my marriage, to take back my children, to take back my prosperity, to take back my job, to take back my ministry. I came to take it all back. Oh, I know I look rough. I know you think you're tough. I know it looks like I won't be able to take my stuff back. But in the name of Jesus, I'm taking my stuff back. David fought with the Amalekites from dusk until evening of the next day. And none of them got away, save 400 on camels. David recovered everything that the Amalekites had taken. Nothing was missing, young, old, boy, girl, or anything else that had been taken. God had a plan for David. For in that same war that David and his men were dismissed from, it was because of the victory against King Saul and his army that David would become the king of Israel, as God had anointed and appointed him in his youth. If David and his men had fought against Israel with their enemies, the Philistines, the people wouldn't have turned to him or accepted him as their king. God had a plan. She has a plan for you. He has a plan for me. Amen. Don't take matters in your own hands. Tell yourself, be encouraged. Inquire of the Lord. Let God give you instructions. If you would just learn to trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own understanding, in all your ways acknowledge Him, God will direct your path. God will work it out. God will bring you through. God will give you back everything that the devil has stolen from you. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. And let's listen to our invitation on Him as we ponder over, as we examine, as we allow the Lord to speak to us through these words today. Be encouraged.
This song says, God's mercy kept me, so I wouldn't let go. Anybody in here ever felt like giving up? Just throwing in the towel, just giving up. I'm not going to ask you to hunch anybody, but just look at them. That person you're looking at is here tonight only because of God's mercy and His grace. Somebody ought to just tell God, thank you for your mercy and your grace that kept me. I was really down. I was really down. The devil really had me. But God's mercy kept me. I'm here tonight because of God's mercy. Come on now, just thank Him. Just thank Him.
I almost let go.
Keep on, God help me. can be achieved.
God kept me, he kept me. But God can't keep you unless you give your life over to him. The Bible says Jesus stands at your door, at the heart, knocking and saying, let me in. I want to be there for you. I want all things to work out for your good. I want to get all of your sins forgiven. I want you to come just as you are because God wants you back close to him. God wants you into her presence. God wants you to be there and be able to talk with him and walk with her. But you can't do this unless you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that God sent Jesus to be your Lamb, to be the sacrifice for you, that you may be forgiven for your sins. So say this with me. If you want to allow Jesus come in, say, I can believe in my heart that the Lord has sent Jesus to die for my sins. I accept him as my Lord and Savior. I know that he rose from the dead. I know he ascended into heaven. I know he sitteth at the right hand of God there to make provisions for me. If you have said that, you have been put on the Lamb Book of Life. You are now in the process of salvation. Jesus is now a part of your life. If you have accepted Jesus, let us know. Amen. Let us know by writing us. If you want to become a virtual member, you can just type it in. Send us in an email. Amen. We would welcome you in. Amen. But come apart. Let God be in your life and with you. And no matter what the situation is, no matter what the circumstances are, you can be encouraged in the Lord. Amen. So let's go right on into our Apostle Creed. Amen. Let us just say it together. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he arose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. May God bless you. May he keep you. May he smile upon you. No matter what situation, no matter what circumstances you're in, be encouraged in the Lord. Amen. I just like to thank again all the members that are out here watching us and listening to us on the phone line. I'd like to thank all the people all across the world, all across this great nation for tuning in with us and tune back us with us again next Sunday at 9:30. Remember, our prayer line is on Tuesday at 7 Eastern Standard Time, 6 Central Standard Time. Amen. Remember that our Bible study is on Wednesday, amen, 6:30 Eastern Standard Time, 5:30 Central Standard Time. Tune in with us next time. God bless you and come and grow with us.